humanitarian crisis, one that has remained mostly faceless until now. This is award-winning Swiss director Markus Imhoff's hard-hitting documentary Eldorado, which looks at the refugee crisis gripping Europe. It's one of the top contenders at the Docaviv Festival in Tel Aviv. Docaviv is Israel's only festival devoted exclusively to documentary films. Now in its 20th year, there are 120 films being screened, looking at a wide variety of issues, from the refugee crisis, to women, to conflict and war. Eldorado follows in the footsteps of asylum seekers fleeing war and persecution in Africa and the Middle East, as they desperately try to cross the Mediterranean Sea, in the hopes of reaching Northern Europe.
It's shocking to see people dying in the sea, and we wouldn't show dead bodies because I can't ask them if they want to be filmed.
Many of those on the harrowing journey never make it to the promised land. The Dublin Regulation, a European Union law, states asylum seekers must remain in the first EU country they enter, which means many migrants eventually reach a dead end and ultimately get dragged into the dark underbelly of organized crime and slave labor.
I was in the camp of the mafia. It's called a ghetto in Italy. People who didn't get asylum work there as slaves, you can say. They earn 50 euros a day under a hot sun of 40 degrees. They try even to send money back home.
But Eldorado is also a very personal story for Imhoff. A story which includes his own childhood experience with welcoming a refugee child from Italy named Giovanna after World War II.
And it ended up to being my first love story of my life. And then she had to go back and she died. So if you have this scar on your soul, you'll never forget it, that it would be possible to love a stranger.
It's this message of tolerance and compassion Imhoff hopes viewers will take away. Eldorado premieres in the United States this autumn. From Tel Aviv, Maya Margit reporting for the Media Line.